I'm going to give two different advice to two different set of people in this video. And then the first set of people is to the YouTube creators, which I feel they should be the ones to be listening to this more, and also to those who might be in the situation of their accounts being hacked, or those that are in the situation of a hacked account. So welcome to CyberSafe, where we talk on online safety, digital safety, and also expose the latest scams and tricks used by scammers around the world. So in today's video, we'll be talking about the YouTube comment spam scammers. Have you ever seen someone that was hacked? Then perhaps the person really needed help to get that account back, and then the person has been doing everything to get the account back. But instead of the person getting the account back, the person got scammed. Yes, it has happened so many times, and then we keep seeing these things. So let me tell you how this happens, or how they get scammed even when looking for help or when seeking help. Most times, the first thing that someone would do, or one would do, is your account got hacked. The first thing you do is to search. You type how to recover a hacked Facebook account, how to recover a hacked Instagram account. You might even go on YouTube and then you search, because YouTube, you get to see the visuals. You see, okay, this is the video of the steps to take. So most times YouTube is the run-to platform for these things. Now, there are lots of videos on YouTube that talk about how to recover a hacked Facebook account, or a disabled Facebook account, or an Instagram account, whatever it might be. And then some people that are in that situation where their account has been hacked, they check these videos, and then some of them might be watching these videos, but before they watch these videos, they check the comment section to see if someone is in their situation. Perhaps someone who has faced such situation before of their account being hacked. Perhaps if someone has gotten a solution from the video, if the video actually helped. Because me personally, that's what I do most times. I check the comments to see if the video was actually helpful, so that I don't waste my time watching the video. So most times, some people get to check this comment section, and then they see something like, you can contact this person on Instagram, or this person on Telegram, or this person on WhatsApp, that this person will help you recover your account. And the point is that you see lots of comments relating to that. But do you know what? Most of these comments are actually scammers. Most of these comments are bot comments, are spam comments, left by either people that their accounts have been hacked, or bot comments, like people who create bots to do all these things for them. So they redirect you from YouTube as a platform to other platforms where they can easily scam you. And so when you see this, you might say, and the funny thing is that most of these people actually post believable stories, like very, very, very believable stories. They tell you something like, 2 weeks ago, my account was hacked. I contacted this person on Instagram, and then in less than 24 hours, the person recovered my account. I'm so happy. You will see something like that. And the point is that you will see it from about 4 different people in 4 different ways, 4 different stories, linking to one particular person you should contact on Instagram. So you might be like, oh, since this person helped these 4 different people, let me go ahead and meet this person. And that is where the main scam starts. So you leave the platform and you visit that Instagram. Majorly, it's Instagram they use for these scams. You visit Instagram and then you check the person out. You see the person saying, and then when you contact the person, you send the person a message. The person will tell you, yes, I can help you recover it, but you need to pay $50. Because most times people that are in this situation, they're always very desperate. And then the moment you go ahead and pay your $50, you get scammed. What I'm telling you has happened to someone, and I've seen it happen a whole lot to so many people. I even went to one video and I checked the comment. I just took time to read over 2.5k comments, and then I saw about 2 people ranting that they were scammed using this means. If your account is hacked or disabled, or you need help, please be careful. Don't contact these people that are on this comment section. The funny thing is that very few of them are actually legitimate, because most people offer their services and then they get money. It's a good thing. But most of them are scammers, because most of them are, you won't be able to tell apart. You won't be able to tell who is a scammer and who is not. And the funny thing is that when you contact this person on Instagram, you don't get to see the person's face. Most of them just use all these cyber images or use cyber names, and then you don't see their faces. And the funny thing is that if you can't see the face of someone, you can't report the person as a scammer. You can't expose the scammer to people. You can't say, okay, this is the face of a scammer, because the person can go ahead and change everything, change his Instagram name and the pictures there, so you won't know, and people won't know if that is that particular scammer. So there's no way you will know. You might be wondering why these people actually collect something as low as $50. You might be wondering, why don't they just go ahead and collect $100 or $500? Well, they know that people that are in this case of getting their account hacked, they might not have lots of money, but anyhow it is, they can squeeze out $50, they can borrow $50 to get their account enabled. And so they keep on collecting $50 from a lot of people. They get to scam people a lot because people get their accounts hacked every day. So if these people get to scam over 5 people, 10 people in a day, they really get to scam as much as 5 or 10 people a day. So you really need to be careful. The creators, you need to take note of this. You can't have people in your comment section misleading other people and getting other people in trouble when they originally came to seek help in your platform or on your channel. You need to deal with this. And then anyone that is in the situation of his account getting hacked, you can contact me on any of my social media platforms in the description and I can help you out with that. But you need to be careful. Don't just go giving. And there's another funny thing towards this. Imagine your account is actually maybe a disabled Facebook account. A disabled Facebook account is perhaps because you broke a community guideline or something like that. Your account was not hacked. But imagine then giving, because the scammer requests for your ID and your password, and then you give this scammer your ID and your password. The person already has your ID and your password. And guess what? For those people that keep using the same password on all social media platforms, you have basically given the person everything about your online life, because the person can access your emails and everything. And the point is that even if this person is actually a legitimate person that is going to help you to get your account back, you've given the person your password and then the person has it. And most people always forget to change the password even after they've helped them with this. Most people forget to change the password. If most of them remember to change the passwords in that, maybe their Facebook account, they forget that they have the same password on other platforms. That is why it is advisable not to reuse passwords. So for the creators, I would advise you to just go ahead and block all those spam comments coming to your comment section. Block them, because they are very misleading. Imagine your subscribers are watching your videos and then they see something of that sort, and then they are misled, they go and they get scammed. What do you think they will think of you? They will just be heartbroken. Most of them will unsubscribe and then they won't even like to hear anything about your channel. Why those that are new? And then with topics like that, you get people to your channel. So imagine someone coming to your channel for the first time and then seeing those comments and then the person got scammed. How do you think the person will feel? You will just get to lose subscribers. So it is advisable you block all those spammers. Like me personally, because of the type of videos I do, I get to receive those comments, but they don't appear in my comments because in the back end I have blocked all those comments so that those comments don't come and they don't mislead my subscribers or mislead likely subscribers or mislead people coming to seek help for certain situations. So I've blocked those things, and every YouTube creator should block those comments. This happens to most people that have all these tech channels or those that have all these tutorial or educational channels. So it is very important you do that now. If you've not done that, block them. There will be a link in the comment section below for a video where you get to see the keywords that these people use most times. So once you block those keywords, those comments will not enter your comment box or your comment section. So that's just what I wanted to share today. This scam is working. Even in 2021, it's part of the 2021 scams that are prevalent. People are using it and it's been working. If you go and check all these videos I'm talking about, you see it a lot in the comment section. If you've missed any of our videos on this playlist, go ahead and just click on the playlist and enjoy the videos we have for you on this playlist. Remember, your online safety is key.